Welcome to Spotlight 5. I'm Sally Spitz, and I'm so glad you've joined us today to see who's in the spotlight. The key to preventing lead poisoning in children is education. Kimelon Merriweather of the City of Cleveland Department of Public Health and Dr. Edgar Jackson of EBJ and Associates are here to talk more about the efforts to get the message out to the public. Welcome to you both. Doctor, let's start with you. What are the blood lead requirements for children?
There's federal law that says children ages 1 and 2 should be checked for lead, all children, and 3. And if somehow that's missed, then it should be carried to a little later age, 5 and 6.
Even. So what are the signs and symptoms of a child with lead poisoning?
It can be very subtle. I mean, very often children may complain of some muscle aches or some fatigue or weakness, fairly common complaint in children. But it's very hard to pick up just from symptoms until people are poisoned. Once a child is poisoned, then there's altered behavior, some even altered mental status. Sometimes children are hard to arouse. They look sedated.
And Kimelon, let's talk a little bit now about getting that word out and resources that are available for parents out there. Tell me about what you guys do at the Department of Public Health.
Well, our first function is to educate the public. We have home repair grants available at the city and county that people can use to help make their homes more lead safe, helping to make their homes to abate any lead that may be present in the home that may poison their child.
So is this still a prevalent problem in the city of Cleveland?
Unfortunately, it is, and most of our first ring suburban neighbors as well, because we have so many old houses here.
So I was going to say, where is it predominantly found, and how did the children actually get poisoned?
Most of our kids are actually poisoned from household dust coming into contact with it, getting on their hands and their fingers, putting their hands into their mouths, from past use of leaded gasoline. So dust can settle on their hands, or it can settle on furniture. They can track it in from the porch, and that's how the kids get poisoned.
So what do parents do to protect their kids?
Good hand washing, good diet, high in iron, calcium, and vitamin C, good housekeeping. Very simple things.
And doctor, how does one get tested for lead poisoning?
It's a simple blood test.
Oh.
So it's not difficult at all. The key is to get to the doctor, and the staff can do it.
Once a child has lead poisoning, then what? What do you do?
Then it is treated with groups of medicines we call chelating agents that will bind the iron and take it out of the system.
But obviously, early detection is key here.
Absolutely, because we'd like it not to get to a level where you have to bind it.
Okay, great.
We'd like to really prevent it.
Thank you so much, both of you. And we have a couple of websites to tell you about for more information. ClevelandHealth.org or HealthyHomesAC.org. You can also call 216-263-5323. For more information on how you can contact our guests, go to newsnet5.com/spotlight5. Thanks so much for joining us today. We'll see you next time. We'll be right back.